So let's dive right into the presentation. And we have around 20, 25 attendees. Thanks for joining, guys. So yeah, I'll start off with let's start with the presentation with respect to what has been planned for today's webinar. Right, so we will be talking about the web report scheduling, right? How we can do scheduling in web reports in Ginesys. And this is like part five of the series that we are having for the webinars. Right, so we'll start off with the scheduler settings. So how a scheduler, I mean, to you know, start off with sending off mails, what are the various settings that a person has to check? And this is basically on the application side or the device on which your application has been installed, right? Or the report server is installed, basically. So that is where you have to check the scheduler settings. And then we will talk about the various options of scheduling that we have. We can do a normal schedule and store that in the server, or we can send out the mail. Instead of storing that in the server, you can send it out to a group of people, a group of mail IDs. Then we have something called as a batch schedule. Batch schedule is when we want to send out the documents with corresponding to a particular email. So let's say I have a vendor for which I have a document that I need to send out to the particular vendor. And there's another vendor for which there's a second document. So each of those various documents should go to the respective vendors in a batch fashion. So that is what you can achieve through the batch scheduling, right? So there also we can schedule the mails. The mails can go out with the attachment, or what you can do is we can save that particular files in the server itself. And next is with respect to the occurrence based document mails. Again, the same similar to what we want to achieve in batch. The only difference is here we will send out the mails based on a criteria. Like criteria is like once the document is created or the document is released, based on whatever criteria that we want to set, there is a certain way we can achieve this. So that let's say you want to save a document or create a document, and that document can go out to the particular vendor to the mail ID, right? So these are the various things that we are trying to achieve in today's webinar. So let's start off with the scheduler settings. These are some important points that we need to understand while doing the scheduling or mail. Basically, this is our mail configuration. So this is a particular configuration file that needs to be understood before you can start sending off mails. So this is basically the software folder where you have the Genesis report, and you have a folder called as report scheduler. And then you have the XML, which is basically having the configuration called as the ewebreportscheduler.xml, right? So this XML is where the settings are stored. So this is a snippet from the particular XML. So you see whatever SMTP server that you have configured, whatever SSL enablement you have done, what are the user IDs, passwords, like that. You have to set in this particular file, and this is what the file that is being read each time a mail has been is to be sent out, right? So this is one important setting that you need to do on the server. Another important thing that you need to check on the server is with respect to a service. So there's a service called as Genesys Report Scheduler. So this should be running, and if it is not running, then you will not be able to send out a mail, right? So this has to be active. It should be running. And preferably, you should put the startup as automatic. So in case your system gets a restart, and this service should be online automatically. Apart from the XML file, the server setting, there's another thing that you need to check is with respect to the Exago admin, or rather the web reports admin. So this is something that you will see once we go into the the demo part, right? So this is what we need to check to make sure that your server is accessible. So all your settings are done and your report engine is able to access your scheduler service, right? So let's now go on to some practical report. Then we will be able to see. I'll just quickly show you the settings that we just saw some time back. So in the report scheduler, this particular folder, you would be able to see the particular settings. Let me show you that particular setting. Right. So this is your file that just shown in the PPT. Right. So this is the setting that I was talking about. And apart from this particular setting, there are various other settings, which probably, you know, once you start working on this, this is something that people would like to, you know, deep dive into. But for time being, if you have any queries on this, you will have to drop a request to the support team and they can put the settings on this. Right. So this is the XML file going. Am I audible? Hello. Can someone write in the chat if it is audible? Okay, great. So I have people saying yes. Thank you. Right. So I'll resume sharing. Yeah. So this is the part we were talking about in the XML, right? Apart from this, as I showed you earlier, we also have the service. So this should be up and running and the startup should be automatic, right? So this generally is activated with your Ginesys web report installation. So this is not something that you need to worry about, but in case you're not able to see your mails, this is a place where you should start looking. So if this is working or not, this is running or not, right? So in case of a restart, probably you see that your batch mails or mains are not getting, it's not reaching you or it's not reaching a vendor, then this is probably where you should start looking from here. And then if you still don't get it, you will have to, of course, raise a ticket with the support team. So yeah, now coming to the setting which I was talking about earlier. So people who have access to the server side of web reports, right? So there is a particular general setting called as scheduler setting. So if you double click on this, you will be able to get the various settings. And this is the particular scheduling thing that I was showing in the particular slide. So this particular configuration should be popular. It should not be, basically this is null or blank in your first installation. So this has to be checked that if this has been correctly populated, and you can check that through this button over here. If everything is fine, then it will say the connection has successfully. Yeah, so this says the connection for this HTTP port 2001. This is the same port that you have configured on your XML file. So this port is successfully, you know, you are able to connect, right? So this is the initial checking with respect to the schedulers. And if all of these are fine, then you are ready to go. So let's start off with one very important thing with respect to scheduling. I will not go into the design of a report. I'll just show you a few ways you can you know, use your report. So this is a document report for sales invoice, right? I quickly show what this contains. So basically, this will have your normal information with respect to the sales invoice information, the vendor information, reference site information, and then of course the sales invoice information, right? So this is something that you know the output of what this contains, or most of the people would know that, right? But for this particular report, there is a setting. Why is the setting required? I'll just quickly go to that and then probably we'll be able to understand. I've named my report as sales invoice GST with a suffix as webinar. Spelling wrong. And in your report repository tab is where you would see this configurable view with respect to the report, right? So this is my report. And there isn't something called as an output configuration. So when you right click on this particular report, there's an option called as remove. That is not what you want to click. You want to click on the output configuration. Now in the output configuration, this is something that I have already done to save time. So this is the particular path on which I want to save my report output. In case I want to, I don't want to send out the mail. I just want to save this report in the server itself. So this is the path where I want to save my file. And there are two options which are like independent of each other. There's something called as a schedule output file name. So this is basically when you don't want to schedule it through a batch process, a normal process you want to send out. We'll know the difference once we go into the each of this particular option, right? So there's a normal process when in that case, it just saves the report with the schedule name, right? So if I create a schedule as ABC, we'll come to that again. Once we start scheduling a report, whatever name you create for that particular schedule, it will save the file with this particular file name. And there are various options that you have. So if you want to save it with the time, date, report name, you can choose that, right? So that option you have while saving the file. So the file name will have this particular nomenclature. So to differentiate two file types, one is a schedule and one is a batch output, right? So what I have done is in case of a schedule, normal schedule, I have just used the schedule name. Whereas in case of batch output, I have used the name and the invoice number. So since I am doing it on a sales invoice, I have a field called as invoice number. And if I prefix it with a batch underscore, then I will be able to save the file or generate the file rather with this particular nomenclature. So it'll have the schedule name. Let's say the schedule name is ABC. So ABC and then the invoice number, say it's INB001, something like that. So the file will be saved like with this particular name. So whichever file that is, if it is a INB002, it will be saving as INB002, ABCD INB002. So this is something that is very important. You have to save this, do a okay here, and then you have to save this. Once you have made changes to this output configuration, once you have done all your things that you need to do, you need to go and save this. Only then this particular changes what you have done will get reflected. So once you have done this particular configuration as well, you can now go to the report part and you can start sending out this report. So let's start with one of the most basic thing, which is probably you just don't want to do anything. You just want to send out the email of this particular report. There is an option when you right click on the report, you have an option called as email report. Again, if your settings are not proper, you would not get these options, right? So this are dependent on your settings. So the first thing I want to do is send out a mail with a PDF format for this particular report. This report doesn't have any filter. So what it will do, it will essentially give me all my sales invoice information. So in this particular instance, I have around 120, sales invoices, right? So it will send out the mail. Now, where do we check if the process has been initiated or not? There's something called as a... So what I did right now is just right-click and send the email, right? So this is... If you want to check the progress or manage the schedule reports, you need to click on this, right? So this is where you will be able to see whatever processes that you have created, right? Let me just close and reopen this. So I just created this particular invoice and it was sent immediate. So it is now in a running state. So it's still in progress. And once it is completed, it will show the status as complete and the mail will be fired. Right, so let's wait for this to complete. Let's just refresh this. It says it is completed and there's another status which is running. Okay, let me quickly check my email if I have received this particular male. So this is the mail that I just sent out. So it says 0 minutes and it contains my attachment. So this is the server through which I have sent this mail. This is the attachment that I just got generated and it has around 113 rather. I hope you are able to see this. One second. In case you are not able to see, let me just reshare my screen. Yeah, okay. Yeah. Right. So I was saying that you will be able to. So the mail has been, the attachment has been sent to my mail. But since this didn't have any filter, it sent me all my 113 files, or 113 documents that are there. Right. So this is a normal thing. Of course, you can set filter on while doing that. So if you want, if I want to filter out some data, you have to, of course, change this. You have to go to the edit and let's say you want to send out mails only for today. So the sales invoice that are created only for today, that you can do through the filter option. So once you send an email on this particular new report, if I change this filter, I'll quickly show you that. So sales invoice header is where I will get this created on. Okay, let me move this because today. Okay. Okay. And I said this date. Greater than or greater than yesterday. Right. So if I say greater than yesterday, then also I will be able to. I save this report. And now again, I just right click on this and send the email. The same mail ID. So ideally this should give me just one, I just did one document today. So it should give me at least, at max one document. So I just, if I refresh this, it will show me that this again, this particular document has started running. Since there's not much other schedules on this, so it started instantaneously. But if there are many other schedules, which are pre-scheduled, so it might not be always that it will be running instantly. This is totally dependent again on the settings that I was talking about in the start of this webinar. So it basically defines how many jobs or batches that you can schedule parallel. So since there's not much on this particular server, I'm able to do it instantaneously, but that not might always be the case when you are start doing this reports scheduling. Right, so this says it's completed. So I'll quickly go and check my mail. So this is my mail just received 0 minutes ago. And in this, I'm just seeing only one document, which is created today. So 3rd January, June is where this was created. So this is only one document that I received. So this is one way of using your mails, which is the quickest way you can do it. Then we come to something called as a normal schedule, right? So let me just close manage you. I'm just closing this and probably right now I'll remove the particular filter that I've created or we can do that. We don't like a prompt that. So whenever I don't need this, I will remove it while execution. So what I can do is prompt. So every time I execute this report, this will get prompted during the execution. So I save this. And I close this. So now what I'll do is do a normal schedule. So how do we do a normal schedule? You can right click on this. Just before the email report option, there's a schedule report option. So if you click on the schedule report option, this is where you can check your, this is now where you provide data. So let's say I call it test normal without mailing. So I don't want to send this as a mail. I just want to save this on the server. So I can do that immediately. So if I want to schedule a different time, of course, I will then select the particular time on which I want to schedule this. Then it would not be executed immediate. You can choose the export type that you want. So if it's a register report, probably you would choose an Excel report, Excel output, export type. And there are various other options, right? So right now I'm doing an execute immediate. And of course the parameter here is just about the logo, which I'll keep it as it is. Then coming to the filters. Now this is a filter which says, okay, just created on the before yesterday, I mean after yesterday. Right, so what I can do is I can keep this as it is so that I can just get one document. And I don't want to run as it as a batch. So if you want to do a batch scheduling, this is the option. This is a tab which where you want to go and check this. Only then a report will work as a batch schedule. But if you don't want to do it as a batch schedule, you don't check this option and this becomes a normal reporting style, right? So, and then you come to the recipients. So in this recipient, you have the email results option. So when you say email results option, this is where you sent out a mail and you sent out the report as an attachment. But in this particular case, what we try to do is we don't want to send out the mail because if you remember this, it's a normal mail without any mail or without any attachment, right? So I don't check this option. And if I do a finish, I'm expecting that particular file to get created and get saved in my server itself. Where? If you remember this, this is where I want the files to be saved. The output configuration file. So this is, if you set this, you will be able to, you can just go to the particular folder and you should be able to find the file. Okay. Okay. So this is the one I've just created for. This is the one I just created. The other ones. So this is the one that is created 4:59. So this is the timestamp we have. And if you open this particular file, this is the one that has been created today. 3rd June, right? So whatever I have created, I am able to save that in my repository and there will be no mail that will be sent out. If I go and check my mail, there will be no new mails that I received. See, there's no new mails that I received, right? So now, this is the one without sending out the mail. Now, to send out the mail, what option you need to do is, you just need to go and check that particular option. So what I'm going to do is, instead of creating a new schedule, I'll just edit the earlier schedule, right? So this is the one that has been completed. I'll edit this. Everything else the same, parameters also the same, file filters is also the same. Batch, since this is not a batch, I'm not changing the option. Going to the recipient, putting the email address, email ID. And here I'll put my email address. So kuntal.p@gsm.in. And subject will be test. Normal. Mail. I'll say help. Just put subject line as hello. Right? So if I finish this, again, this will trigger the automatic or the immediate execution of this particular schedule. Now, remember, when you schedule a report with immediate option, so if it's an immediate option, remember that it will only execute once and then it will stop. Ideally, if you want mails to be sent out on a regular basis, of course, then you will have to schedule your report as per the frequency that you want to set. The first thing that I was showing while creating the name, right? So you want to send out this mail daily, or you want to send out it on weekly. So which day of the week you want to send this out? If you provide a recurrence pattern, only then a mail will be sent out on a regular basis. So for that, many of the reports have some filter options. Give me a second. Just provide a check name, right? So you have to provide time as well. Stay name in the morning, weekly on a Sunday, let's say Monday. Right, came in on the Monday, and you have starting date as today. So in that case, you then will be able to, let's say you want to put a criteria that has been created in the previous week. So you can provide with the date filter function, I think, which we have covered in previous this thing as well. So today minus 7 days and today. So when your report is running on Monday, it will start from Monday minus 7 days. So that will be the previous Monday, previous week Monday. Right, previous week Monday. Seems to be stuck. And maybe I'll just check for the mail that I've received. So the earlier schedule which we edited, and from a normal schedule without email, we changed that to the one with email, right? So that has been sent out, and this is again the same mail, right? So normal scheduling of emails, that I hope is clear now, how you can do a normal scheduling of reports. Right. Okay, moving on to the batch tool. But unfortunately, there seems to be some connection issue. Give me a second. I lost connection to VPN, so that's why I'm testing this. Right. Okay. So I was going through this random example where I was saying how we can. Set up the various recurrence pattern and how we can use a filter date filter function to get what we are trying to achieve with respect to scheduling. Right, now let's go back to our example where we want to batch schedule this as a batch. Now, right, let's do that again. What we need to do is we need to create a schedule. The only difference between a non-batch or a normal one with the batch is the batch option over here. Right, so we'll go to that. Test batch without mailing. Right, so if I again do this, but of course this is not the normal scenario. The purpose of batch is to send out an email, but I'm just showing you a feature where we can you know, utilize this particular, you know, report in a particular way, right? So what I've done is I've given it a name. The parameters are the same. So let me just change the filter to, let's say, a date, just the 2nd of April. So anything that is created after 2nd of April will be sent out as a batch, right? So I run this as a batch. The first part of this 2NCC is where you want to get the summary information. So if there is an admin who wants to know how many batch emails were sent out successfully or unsuccessfully, this is probably where you want the mail to be sent. So this is basically, you can send it here. So in my case, I'll put both as same mail ID. Right. Again, CC is not a mandatory field. If you want, you can do the use that. And then is your the batch email field. So again, as I mentioned earlier, you want to send off the invoices to the vendor's email ID, right? So that has to be captured somewhere. And only based on that, it will be able to send out the email. For us, it has been captured over here in the captured the customer billing here. So in this customer billing option that we have, right now there's some problem with the CSS. That is why it's not showing this field properly, but of course we can do that. We can change that right now. Okay. Yeah, of course you will be able to see the full thing here. This particular environment has some issue, which is why you're not able to see the full name. But yes, so you have set the, made a choice of the email field which on which this document needs to be sent out. So now your batch will be sending out all your mails to this particular document, I mean mail ID. And of course you have marked this immediate. So this should go immediately. And the summary of the information should be going to that mail that you have already configured in the first part. Right, so if I just refresh this. So your test batch without email has started. It's in running. Since batch, what it does is it sends out the documents individually. It takes a little more time compared to your normal schedules, where everything is sent out through a one email. But in case of batch, what it needs to do is it needs to break up all the documents individually, you know, loop through the various mail IDs and then send out individually. So it takes a little more time compared to a normal email, normal schedule. So there are a lot of completed schedules, which probably has no significance now. What I can do here is we can just flush this. Yeah, I can do a flush on this. And all those documents that are already completed, which are not no relevance, it will then, you know, disappear. Okay, so the first mail ID is ready. So let's see. Okay, now it started pushing the other mails as well. So for all the document that will be sent out, there'll be each will correspond to a different, you know, instance in this particular schedule. So if you have 10 emails that need to send out, 10 documents that needs to be sent out, you will have 10 rows of this test batch without emailing, without mailing email. Right, so we have now more, I think more than 7 or 8. Probably I should have used the earlier date. I mean, yesterday's date. Probably that would have been faster. So just to take a few questions. So this is going to take some time. I'll just see if you can have some questions meanwhile. Okay, there was a question, how to send the mail more than one recipient at a time. In case of a batch, you cannot do that. I mean, you can only do it through a custom way where you, instead of the vendor email address, you probably provide your email address and the vendor email address and a, let's say, accounts team. So through a custom view, you can do that. But in general, it is always already, it is already only meant to be sent out in a one-to-one fashion. So one document, one mail ID. So that is how it's meant to be. Then there was a question from Rijesh about making full screen. Not too sure what that is about. Can we send two or more report at one recipient in one scheduler? No, each scheduler is corresponding to only one report. So one scheduler is always corresponding to one report. So you cannot club two reports. Mr. Ashutosh Lalas asks, is it possible to send a document report as soon as it's saved? Yes, that is a technique that we will show as part of the third point, right? If you see my third point as of my this thing, PPT was regarding that only, occurrence-based document sending, right? So that is what we're trying to do. As soon as it is saved, there has to be, no, it will not be as soon as it's saved. There will be some delay. And based on, let's say, if you want to say as soon as you created the document or as soon as you release the document or as soon as you update the document. So you have to set this, define the criteria. And based on that criteria, we will be able to set a filter which says, okay, any document that has been saved in the last 5 minutes, 10 minutes, created in the last 5 minutes, 10 minutes, that should be able, you should be able to send out the mail for that. So we'll come to that as part of the next, this thing. Going back to my schedule, batch schedule, right? So, oh my God, there are a lot. I should not have selected so many. Okay. Right. So you've seen this output folder. All of my documents which were created. Right, so first document, second document, third document. So in total, we have around 32 documents, right? So all of those documents were created individually. So if you remember my first setting that was there, I will quickly go back to the setting just for a brief recall. If you remember, the batch output file name was the schedule name plus the invoice number. So if you see this carefully, test batch without emailing is my batch name and then the invoice number. So this is how you should be able to get the file name. So this is how we can create your file, this thing, batch schedules. And unfortunately, I did not check an option which I was supposed to do. Because of which all my mails are also sent out, which was the second part of it. So this, since this particular document was supposed to go to this particular vendor, and then vendor email ID is this. So all my documents will go to the respective mail IDs that are configured. In my case, I have configured all my vendors with my mail ID. So all my documents are sent to me as this, right? So there are various other settings that can be done with respect to what will be the subject line, what will be the mail body, right? So all those things settings can be done. And I'll just quickly say what I have missed, unfortunately, in my just previous demo. What I needed to do while creating the schedule report was, quickly refresh this. And most of them are completed. So first part was creating the file in my local folder, and then it was sending out this. Right. So I'll quickly go to the initial. Here, since I did not check this option out, I mean, had I not checked this option, only the files would have been saved in my local folder. But since I just, from here itself, I did the batch summary, choose the mail ID on which I want to send out. So that I have created, and then I said finish. But what I needed to do along with it is I unchecked this option. Since I kept this as checked, all my mail ID went there. So here you can provide the subject line as vendor SI document, something like that. So all my mails then will have this particular subject line. Then you can provide the information. Let's say you want to give the bank information here. This is where you want to do the payment on this. So all that can be done from this, right? So the basic difference between sending out a mail and not sending out a mail is this particular option. And if you remember the in case of the normal schedule also, it was just the email results. So if I check this, mail will be sent out. If I uncheck this, mail will not be sent out. So that is the difference between sending out a mail and not sending out a mail. So this is the various option for sending out a mail and not sending out. So that was all about batch schedules. I hope you are able to gather what this is. Just quick recap of here. You need to provide the output configuration here of how your naming of the file convention, I mean, what should be the naming convention of your file that you have to define here. And then the next thing is, while creating the report, you need to go to the batch option, check the batch option, and then you need to choose the mail ID. Of course, filter criteria will be as per your requirement. If you want to just see yesterday's documents that were created, yesterday's sales invoice that were created, then you need to give the document criteria accordingly, filter criteria accordingly, and then the batch. So that these two were the normal batch mailing option on the normal option. Now coming to the question that Mr. Amarnath was it? Ashutosh was asking. There is one more thing. Is any training will come for send the mail more than one recipient in future day? Okay. Probably we can take this at the end of the session. I can give you a hint on how this can be done. Right? Okay. Yeah, now coming to the one which is basically occurrence-based document report, mailing. Now, this is generally how we can achieve this is the same process. Let me quickly remove all this. Okay, before going into that, this as I was showing in the batch mailing, there was a summary mail that was getting configured. Quickly go back to the document here. Here the batch summary email, right? So this email has to be sent out after your batch has been completed. All my documents are created in my local folder. All my documents have been sent out to my vendors. So after that, a batch summary information has to come, right? So this is my summary information, right? It says my document ID 3668, which can be, of course, provided with the invoice number as well. So right now it is just configured as document ID or the invoice ID. So this has been not sent to, since this is not qualified, right? What qualified? Yeah, this is the ones. The ones which are successful are the ones that qualified. Fine. So this document got successfully sent. All these documents were successfully sent, right? So my summary information tells me what have been successfully provided or successfully delivered and what has not been delivered, right? So that information, of course, can be modified further with respect to what information you want to see. So all of my this information is showing my mail ID and my document number, right? So probably you can have the document number and the invoice number. That can also be done, right? So yeah, so the batch summary is where you would see the overall functioning of this. Right. So let me see if I can delete all these documents. And now let's go to the occurrence based. So for the occurrence based, which demo I will show is basically I would create a sales invoice. I will create a delivery challan and I'll create a sales invoice and based on my created date. So as soon as I create my sales invoice, I will provide a time saying that in the next 10 minutes, please send out a mail which was created in the last 10 minutes. That sort of schedule I will create. And that will take care of what that will take care is all my documents will check in the what has completed in the last 10 minutes. And it will send out my document to that particular vendor. Or you can send out to a particular mail ID based on that particular criteria. So it's basically a normal schedule. But since the time captured, it's checking in the last 10 minutes or last 5 minutes, it virtually feels like it is doing as soon as a document gets printed or documents get created or document gets released. So again, as I said, that criteria could be anything. It could be the release of a document. It could be an update of a document. It could be a creation of a document, right? Posting of a document, anything it could be. And based on that, you can probably set up the criteria for scheduling. What I'm going to do is I'm going to create it based on my creation. So let me schedule a report. Check test occurrence SI. Now I schedule a time, so it's around 5:24. Let me put that 7:15:28. And of course, this has to be recurring more often. So it has to occur like, let's say every 2 minutes or every 5 minutes. Let me put it as let me 5 minutes. Then it will always basically ping for the information for which it is already it has been created. Daily, okay, weekly, daily, every 1 day starts today and there is no end date, right? There's a parameter of this. Now in the created on particular filter, what we need to do is we need to do a function, a filter-based function. So what I will do is, I will do a date diff. This is a little more on the technical side, how we need to implement this. So you need to provide the interval. It is basically N signifies minutes. Start time, let's say I provide as now. End time is when it gets created, right? And this, if it is less than or equal to 5 minutes, let's say. So I would say that what will now do a true checking it will do. So if it is within last 5 minutes, you create a document within last 5 minutes, then this criteria is fulfilled and you should be able to send out the mail. Right, so I go to the batch option again, provide my ID. And again, so voice, so other, and this time let us keep with us attaching mail. So I. Now let's go and create a document. Let me create my deliverable server. Let me do one thing. Let me change the time to 5:30 so that I have the time to create a document by the time. Here, let me flush out all the ones that are completed. I don't want to keep them and keep this area very clumsy. Let me just change this time. So change that to 5:31 so that I get time to clean. So I choose my document, this thing, change the quantity, save this. And yes, all is okay. So my document got created with the ID 33. So when this will hit 31, ideally it should, oh, it got abandoned. For some reason it got abandoned. It could take 5 minutes, 3 hours. So less than 35. We'll have to wait for some time because, as I said, this is not immediately, this is not getting created immediately. Uh, Right. Now it is E1 and it started running. I didn't got abandoned. Okay. Something is wrong. I need to find that out. Everything looks to be okay. Okay, way to analyze a scheduling issue is to have the logs. So logs you will be able to find in this particular folder. Go scheduler, logs. And let me just quickly check the log, what seems to be the issue. Got an exception running the web job audience reference not set to an instance. I'm not too sure. Maybe I just need to restart my service or something. Not sure. It's getting abandoned for some reason.
I think Kuntal, actually the process actually I breaked, so might be due to some technical glitches. It might be some issue. If we can just proceed with that. Because maybe due to technical or server issues are there. So.
Yeah, I mean,
it was difficult to find out just in this.
Yeah, it'll be very hard to debug right now on the call.
Right.
So, yes, there's something that seems to have been not working right now. But this is exactly how you can do it. And if required, you can maybe raise a support request as well. If you're not able to do that, if you're not able to achieve what we are showing right now, and our team will help you through training or something, and we'll help you getting your documents, you know, sent out as soon as you create them or post them or release them, whatever you do, we should be able to do that. So, yeah, so that was the training today. And I hope after this, we go back to the slides. I hope after that today agenda, what we covered, you should be able to create. You should be able to see what scheduler settings are. In case they are not running, what normal schedule is with and without emails, similar with respect to batch emails, how you can schedule a batch, with mails or without mails, and then occurrence-based document mailing. So that was it from my side. I think now it's time for the Q&A, unless and until if Navendra, you want to add something, over to you.
Yeah, Kuntal, I think we are done because we have not, there is one Q&A question, I think, yes, how to mail a brand-wise sale report in fixed format to multiple vendors. From single file country, done it to multiple schedule. Kuntal, can you just take it note of this? Brand-wise sale.
So you're saying that Pawan is asking how to mail a brand-wise sale report. So
I think that is difficult to brief currently because get in touch with our support team, right? If it is possible, because it's format and everything, it's something because brand you are mentioning it's maybe category one, category two, which
yeah, I mean for this there is no normal way of doing it. As I said you, that each report is supposed to go out to one mail, and generally it is the lowest granularity with respect to the document that we send out a mail. So if the sale invoice, it will be a per sale invoice, we will set down document. If it's a purchase invoice, then purchase invoice we will send out the document. If it's a payment advice, it will be per payment advice we will send out the document, right? So that is normal functionality works, but there are ways and means what we are trying to get achieve can be done, but then that is something that has to be done in a very custom fashion. This is
even what I can understand from the requirement, that's a brand wise sale. Anyhow, it's some categorizations of items,
right? So right,
barcode label, there's classifications with vendor, might be because if you track the vendor name in the item master, then might be possible. Otherwise, it would not be possible anymore. If you track like if a single item is purchased from single vendor, and if you just track that from particular in particular item, if you track each and every vendor, then might be possible just to send this. Otherwise, might be it would be difficult. Whatever we have understood from there. If you find still difficulties or something you need, you just log a support ticket. Maybe we can check in hands-on, and we can just give you guidance that whether it is possible, or if it is possible, definitely we'll guide you. If it is not possible within this technical this framework, then definitely we'll let you know.
Yeah. So I think Pawan has asked for the follow-up, like mail notification format. Yes, as mentioned by Navendu, you can be mostly you would be able to do it, and now, but it will depend from case to case. So it will be best if you can raise a particular sub request, and then it will be answered accordingly with detailing and all this information, right? So going to the next question of Seema Agarwal, she's asking, what is the purpose of an output configuration for web reports, though web report server as many of our schedules are running without it? This is with the purpose, as I showed you in this particular case, that if you don't provide a scheduler configuration, your default naming, let me just quickly share my screen and just show you what it does in case of a normal without scheduling, right? Quickly show you that. So if you see this particular
Kuntal, actually when you are just showing this screen, and just I just to add here, like purpose is sometimes what happens that some vendors or some your partners who do not want to have the reports or something in the mail, because mail is a junk, like every time some mail is coming, somebody needs to save it, then they can act upon that. And sometimes it happens that the data is directly they want in their system, and that can be true, like if you just save it in some Google Drive mapped folder, so somebody others your partner can take their software, or there's some other.
So there could be a lot of scenarios. The
size is
too big. You cannot send over a mail, right? There are limitations to sending out emails as well. So if you have a, let's say, inventory status sort of a report, so you probably would not be able to
send. Because 20 MB is the Gmail attachment capacity.
So let's say you want to save it in a folder for just for the inventory. So you have multiple folders. One is for inventory, one is for finance, one is for some other module. So for each of those modules report, you want to configure a different folder. That you can do it through the output configuration. And then you, of course, the most important part is the naming convention. So if you created one which is default and want to save it on the folder, this is how your file name will look like, right? So this is not something that you would be able to understand, right? This is something which is basically the system ID. So probably would not be able to see, but these are all, of course, output files. So you, whatever configuration you do on the output configuration, the naming will be then adjusted to your requirement. And then it will be in a formatted way, which you will be able to understand. Like in this particular case, if you go to the output folder, this is now tell me which schedule it has been using and which is the document number it is providing, right?
So it's basically optional, like email will always fire, but if you want that something along with email, you want to save it somewhere directly, you can just add up on that. I think we have made it.
I don't see any further questions. I think Vyomika, in case you have further questions that comes to at your end, you can probably forward that to us. But I think there are no further questions right now.